Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about media. Basically, how you upload media, how you access media, and how you can add media on the fly, or kind of be proactive about it and add media before you start writing content. So, let's go to our dashboard and we'll look at how to add some media. Click on Media, click on Library. You'll see that I have a few things in here. I'm going to delete those right now and show you how to add them. Okay, so there's nothing there. So let's add new by clicking here or here. Makes no difference. You select files, and then we're going to select that button. And then you can change the title. The title is actually just based on the file name, but you can change the title, which is important. You want to change the title, the alternate text, and optionally the description. The title is very important for SEO purposes, as is the alternate text. You'll see here that if you copy and paste this file URL, there's the icon right there. Okay, so that's the actual path to that file. So if we click on Save All Changes, you'll note that we now have one media file in the media library. You'll also see that it's not attached to any posts. So let's go make a post. Let's click Add New. We're going to call this Media Example Number 1. And we're going to put some media right here. Okay? So there's four types of media. There's images, like pictures. There's video, like something you'd find on YouTube. There's audio, which is like MP3s that you play on your iPod, and this one's basically other. So if you want to add a picture, you do this, and you'll note that on this box that appears, you can choose from three different places, and in a minute I'll show you a fourth one appears kind of magically. So you can choose from a location on your computer, you can choose from a URL, or you can choose from the media library. So since we've got something in the media library that we just put there, let's click on that. And then you see that the one thing that's in the media library, click on Show, then it shows you all the stats and meta around it. If we want to left align it, center align it, or right align it, or none, let's show you what center looks like. And then just simply insert into post. And you see how the icon or the picture is put right in the middle of the post. Okay, let's look at this piece right here real quick. If you click on that image, you can click this button and delete it, or you can click this button and edit it. And you can edit things on the fly. So again, you could change your title, you could insert some alt text, which I highly suggest. Here's your link URL again. You can put a caption on there, but if it's a small picture like this, the caption's going to be way bigger than the picture. That looks kind of silly. You can change your alignment here. In the advanced settings, you can actually put a border around it. So let's put a big thick border around it. 5, and then update. See how that big thick border appeared? Let's publish that and see what it looks like. We click on View Post. We have our little icon with a big thick border around it. And it is centered all within the post. You can't look at this area here, the sidebar, as being part of the overall content. The content's actually in this box right here. Okay. All right, let's look at another way to deal with media. So we in this post, we actually went and found media that we already had uploaded. Let's go down here and add some media by clicking on that little icon. We can go to Select Files. Note that the default tab is from computer, and also note that a new tab came up called gallery. Anytime you create a post with some media in it, WordPress creates a gallery within that post that contains that media. So if we had three images on this page right here, if we had three images, let's just go ahead and add some. I'll show you. So from computer, select files. We're just gonna add some more media here. Click on select files, and then we'll pick support and open. And then we would add in all this information. We're going to left align this one, going to insert that into a post, and then we're going to add one more. Select files, pick that one, go there, enter in all the information, choose to right align this one, and insert into post. Okay, see how that works? All right. Let's update that page, or that post rather, and refresh and see what it looks like. See, you've got all three of your icons here. Okay, great. Now let's go back and add some more media, and note that the gallery says three. Well, why does it say three? Because we have three icons or three images already included in this post. So that's that. If we wanted to add, for example, a video, watch what happens when we go here. We can choose a video from our computer, from a URL, or from the existing gallery, which would be kind of silly because it's not a video and it's already there. So let's go from URL. Okay, let's go to YouTube real quick. We'll pick some video, whatever this is, and we'll just copy and paste this. Turn off the sound first, and then go back here, paste in that URL, and then say example video number one. Okay, insert into post. Now what's going to happen here is there's a link inserted to that video. Let's update. Go back and look at the post. See there's a link here, and when we click on that link, we're going to be taken to this YouTube video. Okay, that's that. Now you can do the same with audio or with other media. And by other media, we mean anything that's not an image or music or a video. So it could be a PDF, for example. All right. You can add a PDF by clicking on this little link here. All right. That's really all there is to do with media. Okay. See you on the next video.